I'm no longer a slave. Thank you. let your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let your kingdom come in our lives. Let your will be done in our lives on earth as in heaven. Lord, let us be a reflection of what heaven is here on earth. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not bring us into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Lord, yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory. You're the only one that matters. You're the only one who's glorious. Forever and ever.
The Lord gave me a word, and it was really blessing me and giving me direction. And as worship was going forward, I felt the Lord say this could bless the body. So I'm going to share it with you all. You are a skillful and faithful warrior. Arise and take your rightful place. In my name, tear down strongholds, resurrect and breathe upon dead bones, distinguish between my plans to rebuild and restore, and from those plans I have to tear down and bring to naught. For my paths are mercy and truth. I am blowing my breath and my life into my church and into my people. But those of my enemy, I am cutting off at the root. Leaves leaves, opinions, and soulish arguments are like vines creeping and choking the life from my people. But no longer. It is now time for the burning of the chaff, the weeds that would choke out life from my people. For a while, it seemed as if I was absent, but no, I am long suffering for my people. Abide, abide, and take rest in my presence. Stir up the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Be mindful that my enemy is determined to take down as many as he can. By repenting, your soul comes to a truth, knowing it is not God, and the enemy hates this. My enemy's tactic is to deceive my people with a false sense of power, dominion, and willful desires. But I say, come unto me, the author and finisher of your faith. For no one has given all on your behalf other than me, your Savior and the lover of your soul. Be strong and of good courage, stand firm, and let not your hearts be troubled. Fret not over what evildoers do, for their exploits will be exposed and consumed by my fire. Praise the Lord.
When we were singing about the glory of God, I felt that the Lord said, we so desperately need the glory of God. A touch is not enough. A touch is wonderful. But I felt like he was saying that when the King of Glory is allowed the freedom to come in, and we have to allow him to come in by letting go of everything and giving him all the ground of our heart and our mind over to him. He said, when I come in my glory, I will heal the past that keeps tormenting and take it away. The past is what fights us and tries to keep us from going, enjoying the present and going into the future that God has planned for us. And he said, in the glory, when you give me everything, I will wipe away the past, the regrets, the shame, the guilt, the condemnation. Everything from the past will be washed away and we'll never have to deal with it anymore, so that our presence can receive him and his word and be washed, so that we can step into the glory he has planned for us. So I'm just asking us to let go. Trust God. Don't be afraid of his glory. Don't be afraid of his presence. He's not angry with us. He desires to heal the heart. He desires to heal everything on the inside of us that is broken and restore us to the joy of salvation, the joy of his presence, the trust of a child with their God, their Father. And as we are healed, faith will arise. Strength will arise. Purpose will arise to heights we've never experienced before. I hear him saying, I long to come with my glory. Give me permission to have your heart so that I can heal it, restore it, and put you on the path that I have destined for you since before eternity. Oh, God.